Eye on Gauteng, brought to you by the Gauteng Department of Economic Development.
Unzandile, big thing is funding. This seems to be the water that actually nurtures the plant of the arts, and it looks like that tap is running dry.
Yes, well, as government generally, we are faced with the challenges of funding simply because of priorities. You know, if we were to look at issues of the arts compared to issues of socio-economic issues, then you will see that we are spending more money in education, in health and housing. Not that we don't value the importance of the arts, but in terms of prioritization as government, there has been an attempt really to spend more money around those issues. However, the little bit that we have, we really have been able to support some of the key programs that are beginning to stimulate a growth in the province. Mm-hmm. Some of the activities that I've seen here, like the YFM and some of the few programs, are the programs that we support with the limited resources that we have as government.
When you say, Mzwandile, that you have limited resources, can you give us a figure? How much is allocated to the Department of Sports, Arts, Culture and Recreation?
Well, in total, the department is allocated about 355 million rand, of which about 120 goes towards salaries, and then the rest to programs.
Okay.
And other overheads in the department.
Well, let's go to Marcus. Marcus, 355 million rands, not enough?
I don't think it's enough. I mean, surely you have to know that in a province like Gauteng, we probably have over 250 groups and mm-hmm. institutions that practice arts. And mm-hmm. and that's probably a very small estimate. And everybody needs are not the same. So that amount of money probably won't be enough. For instance, you know, in opera, for us to do a proper production, one production that will be proper, we need about 5 million rands to do. And throughout a year, as a company, you would need to do about 5 or 6 productions to be able to sustain yourself. Mm-hmm. So you would need, just to start, about 30 million. And that's just one company. So it is not enough. Mm. But at the same time, I'm not going to say that the government is not doing enough for the arts, because yes, we have to recognize the fact that we have challenges like HIV, AIDS, we have challenges like housing, and you know, but at the same time, we also have challenges of labor and creating jobs.
And arts not create jobs?
Well, we do. We do. I mean, my company alone, last year, I think we employed about 500 people across the board, and about 40% of those have not been on a full-time basis, and about, you know, some of those that actually get regular salary from us. So it does create a lot of jobs, but we can't sustain it by ourselves, because no amount of money that the company makes will ever cover all the expenses.
Melissa, how important is funding in your sphere of influence?
Funding is very important, but I think what's more important to note is the fact that this industry, and I'll call it an industry, is not regulated. Not by government, not by legislation.
They are artists. Artists don't
and
need
that
to be
means
regulated.
What?
You know, they should be left to their own desires.
It's an industry. If we're looking at the arts as an industry that has the potential to grow and be self-sustainable.
Do you think it's not taken seriously enough as an industry?
I don't think it's not taken seriously enough as an industry as such. I just think that the arts has tended to be treated as the naughty stepchild or the black sheep of the family, where social issues like AIDS and all of that kind of stuff are brought into the industry or the arts and are explored and are reflected in different ways, but that is not necessarily something that is acknowledged, you know. I think also just our understanding of how vital the arts are as a part of our society, as part of a developing society within Gauteng, mm-hmm. within South Africa, within Africa, is so important that My personal opinion is that we at least need to look at those terms of reference, those terms of understanding, that will lay the foundation for us to develop the regulation, the legislation, and everything else that would need to come.
So we're not short on skill, we are short
on
money.
No, we're not short on skill.
Right. Zandile, just before we go to the break, very quickly, is there any indication to show that the Gauteng department, or at least the Gauteng government, is going to be giving more money to the arts?
Well,
to your department?
Well, there is no indication of extra money. Mm-hmm. However, we have come up with innovative means to interact with private sector funding so that we can source more funding, because we realize that of the total that I spoke about, we must remember that we're not only responsible for the arts, we're responsible also for sports and recreation, so the money gets divided into those. So we really are looking at mechanism in which you can involve national government to invest some of the money to go to private sector, like national lottery and so forth, so that they can invest. Because I think that there is a lot of, as my colleague was saying, there is a lot of interest in the art, and I think that through that we can create jobs, which is one of the primary aim of government. So we are indeed looking at ensuring that we raise more money to support this particular industry.